Welcome, you're watching Reporter's Take. This is Vaibhavi Khanwalkar. The Election Commission announced the dates for the much-awaited Lok Sabha elections over the weekend, and they've made some new changes to the Election Model Code of Conduct. And we've got Nachiket with us to tell us more about this. Nachiket, hi and welcome.
Hi.
So what are these new changes that the EC has introduced?
So the Model Code of Conduct was imposed across the country yesterday, the moment the Election Commission announced the schedule for the Lok Sabha polls. Now, the MCC, the Model Code of Conduct, is a list of do's and don'ts for political parties and candidates for the election campaign period. One addition made to the Model Code of Conduct this time is social media. As we know, social media has become very influential during election campaigns, and the Election Commission wanted to make sure that it's not misused.
Okay, that makes sense. So what are these new rules that they have introduced?
All candidates and political parties would have to submit a detailed list of accounts on social media while the candidates file their nomination papers with the returning officer. Now, all political ads which will be shared on social media will have to be pre-certified by the Election Commission. Moreover, during the silence period, that is the 48-hour period before the voting is done, you're not supposed to campaign. Political parties and candidates are not supposed to campaign. Now, social media will be added to that silence period.
Okay. Okay. So this is obviously the first time that they have implemented rules for social media. They are going to implement. So is there a blueprint in place as to how they will achieve that?
Yes, there is. So yesterday, while announcing these changes, the Election Commissioner said that multiple or other major social media platforms such as Google, Facebook, Twitter have assured the Election Commission that they will deploy fact checkers, they will act against fake accounts, and they will also provide transparency regarding political ads and the funding.
Right. Okay, well, this is obviously the first time that this has been done, so I'm sure that we still don't know how they are going to implement this and how they'll be able to monitor this, right?
Yeah. One important or a major platform which was missing from yesterday's announcement was WhatsApp. And WhatsApp has been regularly criticized for doing little to curb spreading of misinformation or fake news, especially during the election period. And we're really not sure at this point of time about how the Election Commission is going to monitor the compliance of these major social media platforms.
Right. Thank you so much for those insights, Nachiket. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Reporter's Take. For more such news and views, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com. Thanks for watching.